Thanks, Lester. Well, new tonight at 6, saying goodbye to a pet is never easy, but some veterinarians are offering a way to make things more comfortable for both you and your pet. Their idea is at-home euthanasia.
Two on Your Side's Kelly Dudzik spoke to a Western New York veterinarian about why she chose to pivot her career to offer this service. She has the details in this Two on Your Side original story.
You know, pets don't have their own voice sometimes, and I feel like I'm there to help kind of bring that bond together between people and their pets.
Dr. Gundala Dunn knew she wanted to be a veterinarian when she was a little girl.
We have pictures of when I was like 7 dressed up as a veterinarian.
She doesn't go to a traditional veterinary office though when she goes to work. Dr. Dunn goes to her clients' homes where she offers at-home pet euthanasia.
Pets really have become more and more part of our family. And you know, oftentimes when people think of like hospice for their own family, they think of wanting to be at home. And so really this is the same honoring of their pet, their love for their pet and their pet and saying goodbye to them.
While Dr. Dunn was in private practice for 15 years at various small animal practices, 7 years ago, she branched out on her own.
When I started 7 years ago, I think it was because I had said goodbye to my own pets and their own home, and then I had had a few clients that had asked me to come out, and I just found it to be such a peaceful and really private experience where they're experiencing such a sad time, and sometimes being out in public, you know, it's difficult.
Michael Zients is one of Dr. Dunn's clients who said goodbye to two of his family's dogs at home. He says he knew it was the right choice for his family based on his memories of losing his childhood pet.
I went with my dad and it was terrible. The dog was frantic. The dog knew what was going on. And I mean, she was a member of our family. It was just heartbreaking to have her in an unusual and foreign environment where she was uncomfortable and stressed. And it was very traumatic for me. I think I was 13 or 14 years old at the time.
He was thankful to have this option.
She came and spent a lot of time with us, and you know, she answered all of my children's questions, and they got to see a kinder, gentler side of saying goodbye to your animal.
While vets across the country offer this service, Dr. Dunn thinks it's an option new to a lot of people.
Oftentimes they, you know, I hear about having a pet bucket list or, you know, wanting to spend some special time with them before the actual goodbye.
Dr. Jose Arce is the president of the American Veterinary Medical Association and says this became an option for more veterinarians when Congress passed the Veterinary Medicine Mobility Act of 2014, allowing them to take controlled substances out of their offices to provide services at people's homes.
And I think this is something that has picked up because, you know, it's a special service that we're offering our clients and something that is going to make them, you know, feel better at a difficult moment, in a moment they have to make a very difficult decision, you know, with a pet they've loved and lived with for many, many years.
Dr. Arce says many hospitals, including his own, were offering this service before the pandemic made it difficult for veterinarians to do house calls.
It's something that, you know, because of the curbside type of practice that was being done in many, many places, definitely this was something that you know, was a good option.
In addition, this option can also be meaningful for other pets in the household.
Often, both dogs and cats, and even birds, I've had realize that the pet has passed and they really almost say goodbye in their own way. And I feel it helps them accept the passing and, you know, go on as part of the family.
What do you think it means for families to be able to experience this together in their own home if they choose that?
I think it helps them. Well, what I've had owners tell me is that it changes the way they feel about goodbye. You know, so even though it's a very sad time, it can be a very loving time. And so I think it's a chance for owners to, you know, celebrate their pet's life, you know, honor their love for them and say goodbye together.
Kelly Dudzik, Channel 2 News.